Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14 is a few months away. In fact, it's about 4 months away, at least from first seeing it, if Apple does what they do every year. Now, every year, they generally have a worldwide developer conference where they show off the next version, and then they'll have a bunch of beta updates for us to test it out, and then it will release to the public in September, along with the next iPhone. So in this case, it would be the iPhone 12. And so I thought I'd talk about the overall design of iOS 14. And the reason I bring this up is the other day I actually posted something on Twitter where I actually said, please let iOS 14 look like this. But before I talk about that, let me talk about iOS 6 and prior iOS versions or iPhone OS versions. And the reason I mention that is this is what iOS originally looked like. If you haven't seen one of these, probably you have, but if you haven't, it's got a skeuomorphic design, or basically bringing real world items into sort of a digital item. So what that means is settings has some gears, and we still see some of this carryover, but everything has shadows like we see in real world scenarios. Music, for example, if we went into music and then we rotate it to the side, we have cover flow, which is something I miss quite a bit. And it's the album art that we could go through. And that was something Steve Jobs always showed in videos. And then photos and calendar and notes, for example. If we go into notes, it looks like a notepad or a piece of paper with lines and then some leather at the top, things like that. And the idea was to make you more comfortable using a digital device. But then from 2007 to 2013, we had this design, and then Apple showed off iOS 7. And iOS 7 has sort of transformed over the past few years into what we have today with iOS 13. And it's a flat design. Originally, it was much more sparse, but we've lost things like cover flow. So even if you rotate, you don't get cover flow, but everything's flat. There's no shadows. There's no drop shadows. There's no depth to it. You do have movement when you move the display where you can kind of see behind it. And we have transparencies, but we don't have depth or what we see in real world scenarios. And since iOS 7 is from 2013 and it's now 2020, we've actually gone longer with this sort of design than we had with the original design. And so I thought it's probably time for a redesign. And I don't necessarily mean an entire redesign. I just mean some icons and bringing back depth. Instead of going to settings and just seeing everything flat, I'd love to see a little bit more depth. And what I mean by that is, let me show you what I meant by my post the other day. This was a post that was done in neo-skeuomorphism. So here you'll see it's got a whole different look to it. So it still brings that flat design, but also adds shadows and depth. So you've got things such as a button or an input or drop down and add user. And there's some really interesting examples of this in this Medium article. So this is an idea for a redesign of Spotify where you've got a tape reel that sort of brings real world, but also to flat design, brings depth back. And it may not look exactly like this, but this is sort of the idea that you get with this. So I'll link this article and everything below. But I wondered what you thought. Does it need sort of a redesign like I'm talking about now? Or do you think they should stick with this current design and just focus on stability? We already know that Apple is focusing on stability and fixing bugs. There's way too many bugs with iOS 13, and it seems like there is every other year. But when the next iPhone comes out, maybe iPhone 9 or iPhone 12 or iPhone SE 2 or whatever they're going to call those phones, those should have a different version of iOS on them with maybe some new features, but with extra stability. And so we will have more stability, it seems. Apple's really focusing on that. But I would love to see a redesign because personally, I was never a fan of flat design. Now with skeuomorphic design with iOS 6 and older, I wasn't a fan of every little thing, such as the green felt used in Game Center. So if we go in there, you'll see they have sort of this green felt look to everything. I'm not a huge fan of that, but I do like some of the design. iOS 6 definitely needed some help with things like multitasking. So if you double click the home button, it would pop up and then you can press and hold and then you tap and delete. So that's how you dealt with multitasking. So certain things needed some refreshing, just like the App Store today versus the old one. The old App Store, Well, it takes a while to load, but the old App Store doesn't look anywhere near as nice. But you'll see we do have some depth with shadows and things like that in the App Store. So there's things in the new App Store that I like a lot, but in the old App Store, it's more flat, and I think it's less appealing. That's just my personal opinion, but I wanted to make this video and see what you thought. Should Apple really focus on stability only, or should they do some sort of a redesign, make things a little bit more understandable? Some people would argue that skeuomorphism is less understandable. I highly disagree with that. I think the share buttons and everything, especially with iOS 7, were very confusing because people didn't know what it was. So if you went into your homepage on or Safari, for example, and then let's see if we can get that to pop up. We have the little share button here. That's not real clear that that was a share button. So I sort of didn't like when they did that. It took some time to learn those things, but I think over time people have learned it. So do you think we need a full redesign, or should we just have some subtle redesigns, or should Apple just leave it alone? Let me know your thoughts about it in the comments below. Now I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.